Welcome to Comprehensive Current Affairs presented by Narayana IAS Academy. Yesterday marks the 100 years of signing of Treaty of Versailles between the Allies and Germany. This ended World War I. India and Indians have made a tremendous contribution to World War I in anticipation of dominion status and home rule. However, this does not happen. Let us study the contribution. Okay, this is very important for GS paper 1. Firstly, more than 13 lakh Indian soldiers served during the war, out of which 74,187 of them laid down their lives for better future. Indian Army had made tremendous contribution across three continents in Europe, Africa and Middle East. These are the three battles, you can read about them. 11 Indians were awarded the Victoria Cross, which is the highest award for gallantry. Apart from all these things, 100 million British pounds, lakhs of tons of rice, material for war, weapons, etc., along with many animals were provided by India to British. Gandhiji raised ambulance unit. All these things were done in the anticipation that if we help British and cooperate with them when they are in problems, the British would help us in solving our own problem by giving us self-rule. New York Times in 1918 wrote that the world must pay in India in whatever India wants, for without Indian products there would be great difficulty in winning the war. The commander-in-chief of Indian Army once said that the British couldn't have come through the war if they hadn't had the Indian Army. In spite of this tremendous contribution, their stories and Indian Army's heroism had long been omitted from popular history of the war because of white prestige. White prestige means that if they say that they took the help of Indians in winning the war, their prestige would fall. That's why they didn't bring out these stories. What happened after the war? We anticipated freedom. But instead of it, Britishers imposed Rowlatt Act, which censored the press and detained many political activists without any trial. And worstly, Jallianwala Bagh massacre took place, in which 15,000 unarmed men, women and children were fired upon. As a consequence of these things, Gandhiji started Khilafat movement. Okay. Gender balanced cabinet. This is important from GS1 perspective, and also these are very important fodder points for essay. Okay. Ethiopia and Rwanda have become the first nations in Africa to have ruling cabinets that have women comprising half the strength. This is very important because many of the tribes and people or religions in Africa are highly patriarchal. Okay. This is important because their presidents and people believed that women were less corrupt than men. They would help restore peace and stability. And as a consequence of these things, a higher number of women in decision-making roles have led to decrease in gender discrimination and gender-based crimes. Okay. Now let us study about Rwanda genocide. This can be written in essay. Okay. Okay. Rwandan genocide is genocide against Tutsi. Tutsi is a tribe, and this was perpetrated by Hutu majority government. This civil war took place in 1990. This was only for 100 days. Okay. But let us look at how much damage it did. An estimated 5 lakhs to 10 lakhs Rwandans were killed in 100 days. Out of which 70% of Tutsi population was eliminated and 30% of Pygmy Batwa tribe were killed. This is known as genocide. This genocide was widespread slaughter of Rwandans ended. How did it end? These Tutsi retaliated back and 20,000 Hutu tribes became refugees. At the end, no one benefited out of this civil war. The worst part of the civil war is that rape was used as a tool. Some experts say that 2.5 lakh to 5 lakh women were raped during the genocide. In 100 days, just 100 days, all these things took place. So this has destroyed Rwanda. Okay. The government and many institutions has collapsed. Okay. and the country had to be started from the scratch. There was nothing. However, within 20 years, Rwanda achieved remarkable progress. Firstly, 64% of seats in Rwanda's parliament are won by women. Okay, this has raised the status of women. These women are today at the forefront of decision making. 61% of population of Rwanda is under the age of 24. Therefore, Rwanda has made education a top priority. 17% of budget is spent on education. Okay, how much it is in India, you can comment. Okay, 90.6% of the population is enrolled in Rwanda's national health program. This is almost like universal health coverage. Okay, and Rwanda's growth rate today is 7 to 8%. This is almost equivalent to growth rate of India. And this is one of the most important points. Whenever genocides, killings takes place in Africa, nobody gets punished. But this is for probably one of the first time that the criminal tribunal for Rwanda punished the people who have committed the genocide. This is so significant that United Nations Secretary Ban Ki-moon traveled to Rwanda to tell that, okay, the people of Rwanda have shown the world another essential truth. That is the power of human spirit. That is, if human beings believe anything, they can achieve anything. Okay, let us move on. SIMEX, the 25th edition of India-Singapore bilateral naval exercise, SIMEX has begun at the Tri-Services Command in Port Blair. In Port Blair, in which sea? Andaman Sea. Andaman Sea and Bay of Bengal. What are the parts of this drill? Complex maritime combat skills, including missiles and torpedo firing, and intensive professional exchange on the port. The military cooperation between India and Singapore has increased due to India's active policy. Recently, the mutual logistics support agreement was signed, which gives India access to Changi Naval Base. See in the map where this naval base is. Okay. Inspire 2018. The inaugural of the International Symposium to promote innovation and research in energy efficiency. This is related to energy efficiency. Okay, who organized it? Energy Efficient Services Limited organized it in help with World Bank. What is this symposium focusing on? Enhancing grid management. Grid management, why is it important? India today is not a single grid. The North India is under one grid, the South India is under one grid. If you remember, in 2013, due to a grid failure, the whole of North India did not have current. Delhi Metro stopped. Okay, to prevent those situations in the future, grid management has to be enhanced. E-mobility. You know why e-mobility is important and what are the benefits out of it. And financial instruments and technologies for energy efficiency in India. Okay, to support these investments in new, innovative and scalable business models, the Energy Efficiency Services Limited and Asian Development Bank signed an agreement with Global Environmental Facility. GEF is a financial body set up under UNFCCC. Okay, both of them gave a 13 million grant. They have established Energy Efficiency Revolving Fund. Revolving fund means that out of 13 million, if somebody takes off 3 million, that 3 million will be replenished back. Okay, this Energy Efficiency Revolving Fund aims to expand and sustain investments in energy efficiency market and build market diversification and scale up existing technologies. Okay, thank you. See you tomorrow. If you have any doubts, you can comment or message me.